Alright, dickheads, I'm your chunky messiah Ethan, and I'm just here with Samar. This Shadowrun Dragonfall, Director's Cut, and that their PC. And I have looked into what we were supposed to do. We, it seems, had to talk to Parson, unfortunately. I have some questions for you about the local gang activity. He nods. I'm looking for the guy. Any idea how I could find him? Smile fades in Parson's face. The guy is a dangerous man. Why do you ask? I made a deal with Ulrich. The guy's involved. The guy is almost certainly upstairs, hidden away from the outside world. I wouldn't advise going after him, but if your mind is made up, I suppose I can't change it. Yes, I can tell you how to find him, but I'll need something from you in return. Yeah, of course you will. Saw that coming. Tell us what you need. A pair of squatters on the second floor ripped the guts out of one of my terminals. They've taken the data jack signal converter, and the terminal will be out of commission until I get it back. A single damaged terminal may not sound like much, but trust me, the entire experience of communion has been diminished by this act of vandalism. I believe that I know the squatter's responsible. The leader's name is Janet. She's a decker of some skill. I don't know what she has planned for my parts, but I do know that this situation will not stand. I cannot allow that another terminal to be damaged. And you want us to deal with them for you? Yes, but not with violence. I want you to talk with them and convince them to bring me my components back. Do this and I'll tell you how to get to the guy. Sounds straightforward enough. Yeah, cool. Yeah, because we need to do that. And yeah, I'm gonna be honest. The guy smelt like a side quest to me. I assumed I'd just be able to, you know, rock up and shoot everyone. But I guess the game has forced me to actually stop and consider my actions for a moment and speak to people. And I don't approve of that. Parson sent me. He wants his hardware back. There's parts to keep us in line, and not just us, but everyone worth a new yen in this hole. Parson can keep running fine, keep running his ridiculous cult just fine with what he's got. But unless we're the only matrix connection these people have. Look, those parts can't be irreplaceable. Let me take a look at your terminal, maybe we can figure something out. The terminal's in the back room, go take a look, but if you try to rip us off, you're gonna regret it. Okay, we are gonna have to pray that Blitz can do something with this. The hacker's terminal has clearly been cobbled together using whatever parts they could find. In spite of this, it's a remarkably impressive piece of machinery. Studying the terminal, it takes almost no time to identify the commands the parson sent you to find. Examine if we can remove it. Okay, so we have no idea, so let's have the teammate examine the terminal. An impulse transmitter. Find an impulse transmitter. Where the balls do we find an impulse transmitter? We can fix the part, cobble you a new one, actually, but you'll need an impulse transmitter. You could do that, Jerry Rig one for us, that'd be amazing. Don't get excited, we still need the part. Okay, so let's go fucking talk to Parson. If there's one thing I love doing, it's negotiating some kind of deal between essentially fucking hardcore WoW RPers. But who've fucking RP'd and WoW so hard, they've turned into a cult. And, just presumably a criminal hacker. That's exactly what I need. I have questions for you. That's for something else. Tell me about this building. I need to get to the basement. Wait, what? They said talk to Parson. Like, why? I'm, like, increasingly concerned that this is just broken at the moment, because, like, that last quest broke? And it seems like, I'm just concerned that there's something going wrong here. I'm looking for a data check impulse transmitter. 1,000, can't you cut me a deal? That part is pretty specialized and expensive, who else is gonna need it? Yeah, 500, thank you. Okay. Or maybe I should perhaps up my reading comprehension because you might have said car. Sorry, it's like I'm impatient. I want to get to combat. I know, it's out of character for me to want to just get to the combat, but I want to move the plot along. I'm not getting paid for this. Just have to go install it. Well, I like how I'm pretending that I have to go install it when what I have to do is tell Blitz to go install it. Modify the impulse transmitter, step away. And we have the signal converter. Not quite sure. Alright, fix up everyone. When's you got your terminal? I've got my parts. Make sure it looks that way. Also, there was a part. Also, there is a. Like, I don't know what we needed the password with her for. I'm increasingly confused. Because we didn't actually need to give her a password. And found out we actually already knew the password. That's what the Shark Tank phrase was for. Covered the parts of your terminal, Parson. Ah, excellent, my brother. Let me see them, if you please. Parson's smile disappears for a moment as he studies the parts. He furrows his brow in concentration. As suddenly as it disappears, the smile returns. Yes, these are the parts that I need. Thank you, friend. I trust there was no trouble, that you were able to attain them without bloodshed. Of course, we never spill blood when we don't have to. That is actually fairly true. I try to talk my way out of situations wherever I can. Oh, that is wonderful news. Truly, truly wonderful. And now I have my end of the deal to uphold. If you're still hell-bent on that meeting with the guy, take the stairs up to the third floor. I found the abandoned apartment at the end of the hall. Look for a stylized M painted on the wall. It looks like two crude lightning symbols. It's his personal symbol. It's an old bookcase. It's a button. How do you know all that? Because abandoned apartment. That abandoned apartment was once mine. In the days before I discovered the piece of communion, I was a very different man. I had need of such contrivances. But not anymore. I'm finally at peace. Yeah, okay, so before you got hooked on World of Warcraft LARPing, you were a very different man. I get it. Go to the third floor. And... is it this one? No, this one isn't abandoned, but... nope, it's not that one. Okay, yeah, it's this one. I just saw them. I'm an idiot. I thought that those markings were going to be like near the bookcase, not on the fucking front. I am just an idiot. I'm very stupid in this video specifically. Ah, lovely. Hello, lads. How it goes? A rail-thin elf wearing a comically ornate wizard's robe, if only he was wearing a comically ornate wizard's hat as well, stands at the center of the room. When he speaks, his voice waves and cracks. So, you're the one who's been turning my home upside down. I assume that you come in search of my head at Ulrich's behest. I would warn you, stranger, he cannot be trusted. Yeah, it's Berlin 2054. Trust is so 2053. That may be so, but I'm telling you the truth about Ulrich. He may have a use for you now, but as soon as this no longer holds, he will kill you. He steeples his fingers, looking for all the world like a kid in a Halloween costume. I would offer you an alternative. What is it that he has offered you for your assistance? I'm sure we can reach an equally beneficial arrangement. Need to go downstairs, into the basement. Well, then our purposes run parallel. To reach the basement, you must use the elevator. The stairs will not reach it. There is no other way. When we took over from the Arbiters, whatever, I removed the power coupling from the elevator controls. I had to keep Ulrich out of his primary armory. In exchange, Ulrich removed the elevator control chip, a petty move, presumably to prevent us from accessing the same armory after he retreated. If you agree to kill him, ow, I just hurt my elbow, I'll give you the part that I removed, then all you have to do is take the chip off of Ulrich's stinking corpse. Trust me, that's the only way you'll ever lay hands on it. Once your usefulness to him has run its course, he will devote all of his strength to crushing you. Honestly, Chief, I don't think I believe either of them. Yeah, I don't believe him either. To show you how serious I am, I'll offer you a further boon for dealing with Ulrich, a magical item of great and inscrutable power. With it, you may call spirit to your side to defend you and crush your enemies. Do my bidding, and this will be yours for the taking. I'd still rather kill you, but don't worry, I'll kill him too. Big mistake, pal. You're gonna burn for that. Somehow I doubt it. I've, like, done a really solid job of fucking you guys up so far. They are furious at that drone. Just fucking hate it. Damn it. Should have taken advantage of the fact that they were just, like, sat that close to that out in the open. I mean, I guess I can still take advantage of it that way. Let's just take control of the drone so our poor little drone doesn't get himself just completely murdered by flying out in the open. Again, I wasn't even using him. It's wild that they were that angry. And I'm just going to put you there. And okay, missed that one. so strange to me that it, for whatever reason, that specific attack changes the sound of the shotgun to the pistol sound, and therefore makes it just a lot less impactful and impressive. There we go, that's what we want. Knock his AP down. No, no, he summoned a beastie. Oh no, two of them summoned beasties. Oh no, good. Okay, something's turned hostile. I'm not sure what's turned hostile. Okay, that fit. The thing their leader summoned. Okay, the thing their leader summoned turned hostile. That's hilarious. These people are... They're such shit mages, dude. They're like so bad at this. It's like just funny how bad they actually are at this mage garbage. I mean, I'll happily take that. Now, everything that's in the room is hostile to him. I mean, seriously, though. What a just actual fool. Hey, how it goes? Wow, I just can't hit anything right now. Okay. It looks like none of us can hit anything right now. On the plus side, I guess we didn't actually need to hit him. Okay. Seriously, just such a non-threatening enemy. Just nothing. Okay, and with that, we have basically immediately already replaced the money we spent getting through this place. It's a good thing we actually took him up on that offer, because otherwise we'd be in a bit of bother in terms of trying to get our hands on that computer part. Send the stash. Again, I've got no use for half this shit, but it just feels like I might as well take it with me. No reason not to. Free crap. Send it to the stash. Some extra cash money. And what's in door number 3? Some cram. Continuing my age-old habit of never using buff or debuff items in video games. Don't know why. Do not know why I'm like that, but it's just something I've never done, and it definitely just makes me objectively worse at video games. Okay, cool. We got the elevator power coupling. One assumes that we can just grab everything he was going to offer us anyway. Yeah, I think we've just grabbed everything he was offering us to kill the other guy anyway. Also, I reckon I'm gonna also kill the... I'm gonna get the guy to pay me for the three amulets, and then I'm gonna kill him and just take his stuff, because I think those guys actually drop something that's a bit more useful to us, and frankly, both sides are dickheads. And I'm just feeling a bit salty. Hey, how it goes? I've got some magnificent trinkets to sell. Thank you. And the guy's dead, and you're going to join him. They should not be allowed this, like, first round. This seems ludicrous. We are literally jumping them. Why do they get to, well, for lack of a better term, like... For lack of a better term, like, reset. There we go. Alright. And let's get the knives out. There we are. And any of you a grenadier? Heavy, you're probably, if one of you is carrying grenades, it's probably you, isn't it? They had to take a guess. Well, actually, if I also had to take a guess, one would assume that they're probably all carrying grenades of some description. Oh, that's a Fizz Adept! Oh dear. Ethan doesn't like Fizz Adepts. Although, it's not actually because of anything lore-wise, it's just something I recall from back when I used to play quite a lot of Shadowrun, when I played like a very long campaign. Remember, in Shadowrun 4th at least, physical adepts were broken as shit. If you don't know what a Fizz Adept is, let me enlighten you. A Fizz Adept is essentially someone who uses magic for, well, as the name suggests, as the name implies, physical stuff rather than, you know, throwing fireballs and such like. Essentially, I think the closest comparison I could think of would be D&D monks. Yeah, that's definitely the closest. The closest kind of comparison I can think of is monks from Dungeons & Dragons. That guy might bleed out in the next turn, to be honest with you. Yep, bled out. How dare you? How dare you shoot that poor, sweet, defenseless drone? Okay, steal their equipment. Ganger mask. Alright. I mean, I'm not gonna wear it, because I don't particularly want to be running around dressed as a fucking rabbit, but I'll take it. That was some unnecessary bloodshed. I approve. Okay, let's go down, fix the elevator. You easily pry the metal casing away from the wall, exposing a mess of wires and circuitry. When you slot the control chip and the power coupling into place, the system immediately hums to life. The control panel's LCD screen flickers, cycling through a variety of symbols, before finally displaying the word online in warm green letters. Down we go. I'm genuinely not sure what to expect down here. Drones, I'd assume. The elevator rumbles and clanks its way downward into the guts of the old Seda Krupp development lab. 18 years ago, this place and the project that was being developed here disappeared from the record books. Thanks to Alice, you're one of the few people alive today who understand why. Alice was clear about one thing. You were here because Apex wants you to be. If the AI hadn't wanted her to trace it here, she'd have wound up as dead as Monica. For better or worse, you're here at Apex's invitation. The elevator grinds to a halt, the doors slide open, and your nostrils are assaulted by 18 years worth of stale air. Apex and the kill switch that will deactivate it await. I feel like we're definitely going to have a conversation with an AI at some point while we're down here. Okay. I reckon, however, we're going to try to deal with what's going on here in the Apex facility as one video. So that is going to be for next time. Bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I might not have, but then that's kind of irrelevant. I'd make the stuff, not watch it. Anyway, big thanks to the names that are and have been scrolling across the screen. Their donations to my Patreon campaign are a huge help to me and the channel. If you'd also like to have your name listed here, follow the link in the description to find my Patreon page. There are rewards and such. Down there you'll also find links to my Twitter, Twitch, and the channel's Discord server. Stuff often occurs in one or indeed all of those places, so go have a look. And if you want more content, I upload basically a video a day. Right, I'm out of time. Bye.